Zoals wij, en toch grote helden, door wat zij voor ons hebben gedaan. Nu liggen zij ver weg van huis in onze velden. Denken wij daar nog eens aan? Near Margraten, if you are ever there, you will find a large American cemetery. Thousands of soldiers lie there on eternal leave. They were ordinary people, just like us, but we call them great heroes when we think of all they did for us. Now they rest far from home in our fields. Do we remember them?
Thank you.
voor ons gestreden. Wij werden door hen bevrijd. Wat hebben zij te veel geleden in die droevige, bange oorlogstijd. Zij hebben voor ons alles gegeven. En wat heeft hen dat toen opgebracht? They fought for us. We were freed by them. How they suffered for us in those agonizing days of the war. They gave everything for us. And what did they get for it all?
order herbs. Everybody, good morning on a day where the weather is favoring us. If we would have had this yesterday, we might have had a different outcome. Good morning to everybody, good morning to Mergeland Mannenkoor. A special word of welcome to the veterans. I'm very glad that you were able to join us and you were on time. Good morning to the representatives of the armed services who are joining us here. Good morning to all the Dutch people who are here and our American friends who are here to commemorate Operation Market Garden. And to commemorate Operation Market Garden in the shadow of the Dutch Carillon. The Dutch Carillon, which is the gift of the Dutch people after the Second World War to their liberators, the Americans who came to our country to liberate us from Nazi oppression. Many of them gave their lives, never returned, to liberate us, and to give us back our freedom, and also, let me add that immediately, to help us on our way afterwards with the famous Marshall Plan. Operation Market Garden was not a success. Operation Market Garden was an attempt by the Allies to short-circuit the war, to cut down on the suffering of the European people, and to reach Berlin before Christmas. And to that end, they dropped thousands of troops in the vicinity of Arnhem and Nijmegen, trying to take a number of bridges so that the passage to Berlin would be opened. And unfortunately, they hadn't reckoned with the resistance on the German side. And in those fateful 9 days, more than 70,000 Allied troops died. More than 70,000 young boys and some girls died, and sometimes lots of them jumped. Sometimes they didn't even make the ground to life. Sometimes their World War II experience was a 3-second jump from a plane. Operation Market Garden shows us the enormous sacrifice, the enormous willingness, the enormous gratitude that we should have for those young boys and girls who came from far, far away to a country that they did not know, to fight against an enemy that they did not know, and to fight for the principle of liberty, for freedom, to liberate a people that was thousands of miles away. It reminds us that there were parents in this country who sent sometimes their only son off to war at the tender age of 18 or 19, who never saw that son back, because that son gave the ultimate sacrifice, not for the freedom of his village, not for the freedom of his state or of his country, but for the freedom of a country that he did not know. He gave it for a principle, the principle of freedom. Therefore, this Carillon is a, for us, the Netherlands, is a sacred ground, is a token of our eternal friendship. The failure of Operation Market Garden cut my country in half. The South was liberated, the North was not. And the North went into a winter of starvation. We call it the Hunger Winter. 22,000 people died of starvation in the North of the country in that final winter of 1944 and 45, while the South of the country enjoyed liberation and enjoyed the support of the Allies. 22 countries died of starvation in a country, and it's ironic, that's by now the second biggest agricultural exporter in the world. We are an agricultural country. We can feed our people, but not in that fateful winter after Operation Market Garden. What does that say about Market Garden? It says about Market Garden, I think, and that's the importance, that if you want to win freedom, if you want to defend freedom, if you want to fight for freedom, you have to take risks. And I think we should be eternally grateful for the Allies that they took those risks. And they took those risks at an enormous peril for themselves and for the soldiers that they put into harm's way. It's not the fault of Market Garden that people died in the Netherlands. Moreover, I think we should all the more grateful that they took that enormous risk to try to save us, to try to save us before Christmas 1944 would become. Many of the soldiers who died in Market Garden were buried at Margraten. Margraten is the largest American cemetery by far in the Netherlands. 8,301 American soldiers are buried at Margraten. More than 1,700 names are engraved on a wall. Those are the soldiers we have never been able to find and couldn't give them a last resting place. Margraten is a special cemetery for us, and I'm very happy that I have the president here of the Association of the War Graves, Margraten, who will tell later on a little bit about the cemetery of Margraten. The choir that you see here that sings for us are the sons of the people who dug the graves at Margraten. They have a direct link to that cemetery. And they tell their story in their songs. They tell the story of their liberators. They tell the story of hope. They tell the story of the enjoyment of freedom that we have experienced since 1944 in the South, since 1945 in the North. And they do that in their songs, and they perform their songs all over to spread the word of our gratitude for the state in which we live, the liberation that we experience. We stand here in front of the Kurilin. As I said, that was the gift of the Netherlands people to the American people. There are 50 bells in the Kurilin, and you can see it is in need of repair, and I can tell you we will repair it. We will start repairing it next year, and I very much hope that we will see a new Kurilin by the time we celebrate our liberation and we commemorate the death of the war in 2020 on the 4th and the 5th of May. If everything goes well, there will be a new Kurilin and there will be new bells. Having a Kurilin and having bells is a special signal. Bells are the messenger of good tidings. Bells are the messenger, in our case, of freedom. Bells are the messengers of gratitude. There's an old story, and I think it's true. In the olden days in Europe, the bells were made of bronze. And bronze was used for the making of cannons. And when the war was over, you would take the cannons and turn them into bells. And bells would signal the freedom and the peace that would break out after the war. For the same token, when the bells were taken down, you knew that trouble was on the horizon and war was coming. I'm very happy and proud that these bells that are here, have not been taken down for more than 50 years, that we haven't seen war since 1945 in our country, that we lived in prosperity, that the Americans, via the Marshall Aid, helped build up my country to what it is now, a prosperous, peaceful country, a country that will not forget its friends, a country that is opening and welcoming to people from other parts of the world, a country that knows what freedom is and will never forget how we got that freedom. That's why we still celebrate our days of remembrance, our Liberation Day, our Memorial Day, and today, the day to celebrate, to remember Market Garden, thanking the people who gave their lives, thanking the parents who gave their children, and thanking this great country that came to our rescue in the moment of our need. Thank you very much.
Oh, Mr. Ambassador Schuer, Deputy Ambassador Mrs. Bakker, Captain Amalan, dear veterans, all civilian and military present here. My name is Ton Hermes. I am the representative of the Foundation for Adopting Graves at the American Cemetery in Margraten. We came all the way from Margraten in the Netherlands to be with you today and to join the Market Garden commemoration. And we is the Foundation for Adopting Graves at the American Cemetery, as I said, and the Minsk Choir from Margraten. We came here to pay our respect to AWON, the American World War II Orphans Network, the children of American soldiers buried at American cemeteries all over the world, and also in our town. And we offer them tonight a musical tribute for not only the sacrifice of their fathers, but also for the sacrifice of themselves, because living and growing up without a father does mean a lot for those families. One of these soldiers buried in Margraten served during Operation Market Garden as a member of the 82nd Air Battalion Division. Second Lieutenant Willis Utecht was a platoon commander in a glider regiment. He enlisted on October 17, 1942 in Marysville, Kansas, during the Battle of the Moke Plain, part of the Operation Market Garden. Willis Utecht and his platoon came under heavy fire from German forces, and Willis was hit by enemy fire. It was the last time that anyone saw him alive. He left his parents, Emil and Helen, his brother Marvin, and his sister Ellen behind. There's a mystery, because his body was never found. So maybe one day he might knock on the door and say, "Here I am." And the mystery of what happened to him was answered when a Dutch farmer named Harry Lamers unearthed a shallow grave while plowing a meadow. And he believed the remains were those of a paratrooper because of the jump boots. Willis Utrecht was identified and buried at the Margraten Cemetery on 16 September 1994. It was the last burial in Margraten. And his name is also listed on the walls of the missing. And since his body has been found, his name has a bronze marker in front of his name. For those who do not know Margraten, here's a small introduction. In September 1944, after 4 years and 4 months of Nazi suppression, American forces crossed the Dutch border near our village. And the 9th Army of General Simpson established its assembly area in the southern part of the Netherlands. And thousands of soldiers were quartered in our homes, in schools and everywhere. Photos were made, local people even got connected to families in the US, and a long period of time they stayed with the people in Margraten in the southern part of Limburg, leading to personal friendships and strong bonds. It was Captain Schaumann of the 611 Grave Registration Company who was ordered by General Simpson to find a location for a military cemetery as a preparation for the oncoming battle. And I am very pleased that Nancy Schaumann, his daughter, is here among us, together with her son, Noel. Welcome. General of the Captain Schaumann found a suitable location in Margraten. And in November 44, the first burial took place. And from that day on, the inhabitants of this small village of Margraten witnessed trucks loaded with bodies driving through the village every single day in the next 7 months. Also soldiers they knew that stayed in their homes. They saw, they heard, and they smelled the atrocities of war. A traumatic experience. And in January, 1945, a committee of citizens was founded because local people felt the urge to do something for the Americans. They went to the American cemetery and asked Captain Showman, "Can we do something for you? We offer you our support." And Showman asked them to provide flowers in the next Memorial Day, May 45. And that's what they did. In May 45, all American graves were decorated with flowers. Local men even were asked to assist in digging graves at the American cemetery because of the number of bodies coming in. In the meantime, American families wrote letters to Holland, to Margraten, and asked Dutch families if Margraten was near, and because their son was killed, and they wanted them to go to the cemetery, make a picture, put flowers, and actually those people went to the cemetery, said a prayer, put flowers at the grave, and sent a picture of the grave to the homes in the States. And this was the beginning of a large grave adoption program. And on May 30, 1945, the first Memorial Day celebration, all over 17,000 graves were decorated with flowers. And in May 46, all 17,700 graves were adopted by local people. And this adoption program we still have in the Netherlands. After the war, 10,000 soldiers were repatriated and the current cemetery was constructed with 8,301 graves and 1,722 names carved on the walls of the missing. All of them adopted by over 9,000 adopting families, schools and organizations. For his brother Marvin and his sister Ellen, and for the next of kin of Willis Utrecht, it is a great comfort to know that his grave has been adopted and that he is remembered by a local family. The adopters of his grave are living in our municipality and they have contact with his niece, Patricia Weston Utrecht in the USA. Together they commemorate the soldier and together they share the story of Willis Utrecht, and together they cherish freedom and peace. And this idea of commemorating together from a shared past and a joint future is a strong and inspiring idea, a phenomenon that has the power to create an essential change in the heads of people. And we are convinced that the idea of commemorating together by adopting an American war grave will motivate more and more people in their daily life. The sacrifice that our American liberators made during World War II is still valuable, even today. They deserve to be commemorated, as they paid the ultimate price for our freedom. Let's not forget.
During the ceremony so far, we sang two songs, and I will give you a short explanation of those. The first song was called "Do You Remember?" The song was composed in the 1970s by the local fellow Huub van Houten on the occasion of performing on Memorial Day at the American Cemetery with his choir. The lyrics are by a local Margraten fellow, Matt Dupuis. As the text says, thousands of soldiers lie there on eternal leave. Do we remember them? The second song was called "Lord, I'm Coming Home." It was composed by American William Kirkpatrick in the 19th century. He was from Duncannon, Pennsylvania. It was based on the story of the prodigal son found in Luke 15. It was sung oftentimes the grave diggers at the American cemetery in Margraten, mostly black soldiers, interred the body of a killed soldier. The final song that we are going to sing in a moment is called "Margraten." It was composed by a member of the local music band, Schintaler, in 1996, and tells about the Dutch visitor to the American cemetery in Markraten. And in the morning, when the fog disappears, he sees the thousands of white marble tombstones. In the early morning sunlight, he stands in front of the grave of Private Washington. And the visitor wonders, would I also do for him what he did for us?
Wereld die verandert te veel. Rust.